In this video, we're going to be finishing our Equations of Circles worksheet on the CUDA software website. In numbers 9 through 14, we're going to be using the information provided to write the equation of each circle. Remember that the standard form of the equation for a circle is x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals the radius squared, where h and k are the center coordinates. So I'm going to have x minus my h value is 13, so x minus 13 squared plus y. My k value is negative 13, so I'll have y minus a negative 13 squared. That's going to be equal to my radius squared, which if r is 4, that'll be 4 squared. So simplifying, I'll have x minus 13 squared plus y minus a negative 13 is the same as y plus a positive 13 squared equals 4 squared, which is 16. So in number 9, I have x minus 13 squared plus y plus 13 squared equals 16. And number 10, they give me the center values. So h is equal to negative 13 and k is equal to negative 16. So x minus a negative 13 is the same as x plus a positive 13 squared plus y minus a negative 16 is the same as y plus a positive 16 squared, and that will be equal to our radius squared, which we need to figure out the radius. Fortunately enough for us, they give us a simple point to help solve for the radius. If the center, looking at a graph, is at negative 13, negative 16, so this point, negative 13, negative 16, and there's a point on the edge of that circle at negative 10, negative 16, so the same value in the y, but in the x, we change by 3. So to get to negative 10, negative 16, we're moving over 3 to the right. So that's a positive 3 for the radius. So if the radius is equal to 3, r squared is equal to 3 squared, which is 9. So my equation, x plus 13 squared plus y plus 16 squared equals 9. And number 11, it says that the ends of the diameter are 18, negative 13, and 4, negative 3. That's the ends of a diameter. So those two points form a straight line. So what we're going to need to do is figure out the change in x, and we need to figure out the change in y. Because looking at a graph, if we wanted to sketch that, positive 18, negative 13 is somewhere down here. That's one point on the edge of the circle, and 4, negative 3, is another edge on the end of the circle. So we have to figure out our center point, which is in here, which is halfway between those two points. And for this, we're going to need to remember our distance formula, which is the square root of x1 minus x2 squared plus y1 minus y2 squared. Or we can write that as x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. Either way, that'll give us the distance between the two points, which will help us figure out the diameter. And we know that the radius is equal to half of that diameter. So once we figure out that, we'll be able to solve for the radius and then use that distance to calculate the center point. So x1 minus x2 squared, so I'll do 18, x1, y1, x2, y2. So 18 minus 4 squared plus negative 13 minus a negative 3, so plus 3 squared. And we're taking the square root of that. 18 minus 4 is 14, and when we square that, we get 196. So we have the square root of 196 plus negative 13 plus 3 is negative 10, and squaring that, we'll get a positive 100. 196 plus 100 equals 296. So the square root of 196 plus 100 equals the square root of 296. So if that's the diameter, we need half of that to find the radius. So if that's equal to the diameter, then the radius is equal to the square root of 296 divided by 2. The square root of 296 divided by 2 will give us our radius. Now we just need to find the center point. So now we can use the distance formula again and eventually solve for the radius. However, let's just make this a right triangle. We know that the radius is the square root of 296 divided by 2. So that radius is this length. Now, fortunately for us, they kept this rather simple for solving for that center point. If x1 is 18 and y1 is negative 13 and x2 is 4 is negative 3, so if we were to look at this like a triangle, we're going to be going down from negative 3, since we're talking about the y direction, negative 3 to negative 13, so that's down 10, and we're going to be going over from 4 to 18, that's going to be 14. And that's where we got our diameter, 10 squared plus 14 squared. So 18 minus 4 was 14, and negative 13 plus 3 was 10. That's why the distance formula works. It's essentially the Pythagorean theorem. So 14 squared, 196, plus 10 squared of 100 gave us the square root of 296, and we would divide that by 2 to get the radius. Now, lucky enough for us, 10 is divisible by 2, and 14 is divisible by 2. So if we go down 5, we'll get halfway to 10, and if we go over 7, we'll be halfway to 14. So going down 5 from negative 3, negative 3 going down 5 would be negative 8. That's going to be our k value because we're talking about the change in y's. And if we're starting at 4 and going to the right 7, that's going to be 11. So that's our h value. So essentially, I made a similar triangle to solve for the center point of that diameter. So now we can write our formula. Knowing our h and k values, if h is positive 11, we'll have x minus 11 squared plus negative 8, so that'll be y plus 8 squared within our formula, because plus k is the same as minus a negative k, and that's going to be equal to our radius squared, r squared. If we square r, r squared equals 296 divided by 4. And that's the square root of 296 squared, which is 296, and 2 squared is 4. So 296 divided by 4 is 74. So 74 is r squared. So x minus 11 squared plus y plus 8 squared equals 74. Now let's move on to number 12. In number 12, it tells us that our center is 10, negative 14. So that means that h is a positive 10 and k is a negative 14. So x minus 10 squared plus y plus 14 squared is going to be equal to our radius squared. However, it tells us that the circle is tangent to x equals 13, which is a vertical line at x equals 13. Now, if we look at our coordinate system, here's x and here's y. If our center is at 10, negative 14, we're at 10 in the x direction, which means the difference between 13 and 10, the difference in our x direction, is 3. So that's our radius. From the center to that tangent line, the distance is 3. So our tangent line, x equals 13, would intersect our circle at 13, negative 14. So our radius is 3, so our radius squared, r squared, will be 3 squared, which is 9. So for number 12, x minus 10 squared plus y plus 14 squared equals 9. And number 13, the center lies in the first quadrant. So this one will help if we draw a picture. The center is somewhere in this first quadrant. We have the fact that the circle is tangent to x equals 8, so x equals 8 is a tangent line. We also have that x equals 14 is a tangent line. So right away, if we were to split this in half, if each of those were tangent lines in the center of those, so 14 minus 8 is equal to 6. The difference between those is 6. So that's the diameter of our circle, so our radius, r, would be equal to 3, since 6 is the diameter, and the radius equals half of that diameter, d, so that's half of 6, which is 3. So that means 3 over from 8, 1, 2, 3, and 3 over from 14, 1, 2, 3. So 8 plus 3 is our center point of 11, or you could think 14 minus 3 is the x value of our center point of 11. So the center falls at x equals 11. And it says that y equals 3 is also tangent. So y equals 3 is also tangent to that circle. But remember that our radius we calculated to be 3, so 3 up from that tangent line would be y equals 6. So our center occurs at 11, 6, the intersection of x equals 11 and y equals 6. So if our center occurs at 11, 6, we have our center and we have our radius. So our radius squared is 3 squared, which is 9. So now we can write our formula. X minus h, which h is 11, that quantity squared, plus y minus k, y minus 6, that quantity squared is equal to our radius squared, 9. X minus 11 squared plus y minus 6 squared equals 9. And lastly in this video, we're going to be going over number 14. Our center, h, k. So h is 0, so x minus 0 squared plus y minus k, y minus 13 squared, will equal our radius squared. And if area is 25 pi, the area of a circle we know is pi r squared. So we'll divide both sides by pi to get that 25 equals r squared. So we don't even need to calculate our radius since, for standard form for a circle, x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared, which is 25. So x minus 0 is always x. So we'll have x squared plus y minus 13 squared equal to 25. And that is our final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Also, go to my geometry tutorial section with more lessons on utilizing different parts of a circle to solve for the radius and center. And if you haven't already, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your classmates.